So it says that the blessings of Abraham might come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ. Come on the Gentiles through Jesus Christ, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through that we might receive the promise through. Come on, somebody want to blow on us. Somebody say, Lord, breathe on me. Breathe on me, Lord. Breathe on me, Lord. Breathe. And God just waiting to exhale on somebody. He's waiting to exhale. He's waiting to blow on you. He's waiting to blow blessings on you. Waiting to blow power on you. Come on, somebody. When on the day of Pentecost, when they were all on one accord in one place, oh, good God Almighty, they heard a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind. Oh, and it filled the house where they were sitting, and they appeared unto them clothed in tongues like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them, and through faith they was filled. Through faith they got it. Oh, through faith they received it. Oh, hallelujah, glory to God. You know, let's benchmark that. I'm going to get to Acts 6 and 5. Matter of fact, let's go to St. Luke, because we need to see what position they were in. Come on, somebody. We need to see what position they were in that set them up and caused them to increase the caliber of their faith. Come on, we need to know that, right?
Yeah.
Because remember, the caliber is power to receive.
Yeah.
Remember?
Yeah.
Caliber means capacity. Okay, capacity means the ability to receive or contain. So they needed the ability. They needed the ability to get this. And this is one of the mechanisms that gives you the ability and also increases the caliber. That allows you to go from this diameter to this diameter to this diameter. So you are full. Y'all catch that?
Yeah.
Y'all catch that?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to show you what allows you to go from this diameter, making it hard for God to blow on you, causing stress in the kingdom to get a blessing to you, causing strife amongst the angels. God, I'm coming to them. They just ain't receiving it. I'm doing all that I can. And it's a struggle because the faith is too small. The faith is too small. That's why it ain't coming like you want it. Your faith is too small. You got to increase the caliber. Makes it a little easier. But you got to seal up the hole so you can receive the fullness. And so look at the position that they were in. And so this is what Christ told him over in Luke 24:46. It says, and said unto them, thus it is written. Now that'll make you shout right there. It's written. It's already a done deal when it's written. Amen. Praise God. When the king writes up, that can't be diverted, pulled back. Amen. Praise God. Denied. Amen. Reversed or anything. It is that right there. Thus it is written. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And thus it behooved Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. And ye are witnesses of these things. Can I get a witness up in here? Amen. Amen. Anybody been redeemed by the blood that we just spoke about? Amen. But can I get a witness up in here? Amen. Amen. Can anybody testify that they're on Christ's side now, that they used to be unsaved, now they are saved? Come on, somebody. Amen. So we got witnesses in this present day hour. Amen.
Amen.
Glory to his name. That repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. And ye are witnesses of these things. Okay? And behold, I send the promise of my Father. Who is the promise?
The Father.
Nope. Who's the promise?
The Holy Ghost
is the promise. promise. Amen. Praise God. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. Who's going to send it? Who's sending the promise?
Jesus.
Jesus is sending the promise. Jesus is sending the promise. I send the promise, this is him speaking. I send the promise of my Father upon you. Remember, he told the disciples earlier, he said, it's expedient that I go. If I do not go, the Holy Ghost will not come. But if I go, I'm going to send him unto you. And he's going to lead you in righteousness. He's going to guide you in all ways for righteousness' sake. He's going to show you things to come. He's going to reveal things to you. He's going to be a guide. He's going to be a comforter. But it's going to be me that's going to baptize you. Even John said, hey man, this comes one that's mightier than I, whose latches, whose shoes I'm unworthy to unloose. He's going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and that with fire. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
So we see that Jesus is the baptizer. He's the one that baptizes us in the Holy Ghost. Amen. Praise
Amen.
God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to his name. So, but look at this. But we're also talking about, because that's vital, we're also talking about increasing the caliber. Somebody say increase.
Increase.
Increasing the caliber. Amen. Of my faith.
Of my faith.
Of my faith.
My faith.
And behold, I send you the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in Jerusalem. What does tarry mean?
Wait.
It means to wait. So, in order to increase the caliber, you got to be prepared to wait. Can't be in a hurry. Can't be over anxious. You got to be able to wait on him. The promise is that he's coming. You know how he's coming through faith. You just got to wait on the prince to send him to. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Shall renew their strength. Shall mount up with wings as of an eagle. Shall run and not be weary. Shall walk and not faint. Give God some hand praise. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah.